Hello again, and again welcome to the channel. There are quite a few YouTube videos featuring a fancy geometric drawing with a separate color for something to be found. Here is my response to that. Three circles with radii 1, 2, and 3 are tangent to each other. Find the radius of the circle passing through the tangent points. As usual, try to solve the problem before we proceed. At start, let's figure out what does it mean that two circles are tangent to each other. Two circles are tangent if they have one and only one common point called tangent point. A tangent point of two circles must belong to the line connecting the centers of the circles, as if the point were outside the center line, a symmetric point with respect to this line would be another common point of the circles. Now we can make a proper drawing for the problem. So we have three circles with centers at O1, O2, and O3, which are tangent to each other. The centers form a triangle O1, O2, O3. As we've seen before, tangent points T1, T2, and T3 lie on the sides of the triangle. Let R1, R2, and R3 be the values of the radii. Points T2 and T3 lie on the circumference of the first circle. Therefore, O1 T2 equals O1 T3 equals R1. Similar equations can be written for other circles. Now we can remove the circles as they are no longer needed. Our objective is to find the radius of green circle which passes through points T1, T2, and T3. Let C be the center of green circle and x the value of its radius. Draw segments CT1, CT2, and CT3. These segments are radii of the green circle, therefore their lengths are equal to x. Consider triangles O1, CT2, and O1, CT3. They have two pairs of equal sides. O1, T2 equals O1, T3 equals R1, CT2 equals CT3 equals x. OC is the common side of these triangles. Therefore, the triangles are equal by three sides, from which it follows that angle CO1 T2 equals angle CO1 T3, which means that O1C is the bisector of angle O2, O1, O3. Another pair of equal angles, angle CT3O1 equals angle CT2O1. Let Φ1 be the value of those angles. In the similar way, we prove that triangle O2CT1 equals triangle O2CT3, from which we conclude that angle CO2T1 equals angle CO2T3. In other words, O2C is the bisector of angle O1, O2, O3. We found that C is the point where two bisectors of triangle O1, O2, O3 meet. Therefore, C is the in-center of the triangle. This suggests that the green circle may be the inscribed circle of triangle O1, O2, O3. However, there is an infinite number of circles with center in C, therefore it is not obvious that the green circle is the inscribed one. Another pair of equal angles, angle CT1O2 equals angle CT3O2. This will be value Φ2. Finally, we prove that triangle O3CT1 equals triangle O3CT2. We get OC3 is the bisector of angle O1, O3, O2. This is actually redundant as we already know that point C is the in-center of triangle O1, O2, O3. However, there is another pair of useful equal angles. Angle CT1, O3 equals angle CT2, O3, and this will be value Φ3. So it's proven that C is the in-center of triangle O1, O2, O3. Now we are going to prove that the green circle is actually the inner circle of triangle or 1 or 2 or 3. For that purpose, we used previously introduced angles phi 1, phi 2, and phi 3. Consider angles near T1. We see that angles phi 2 and phi 3 form together a straight angle. So we write phi 2 plus phi 3 equals 180 degrees. Similarly, for T2 we get phi 1 plus phi 3 equals 180 degrees. And for T3, phi 1 plus phi 2 equals 180 degrees. You see that each angle in the equations appears exactly twice. Therefore, if we add up all the equations, we get 2 times the sum of all angles equals 540 degrees. Therefore, the sum of all angles equals half of that, which is 270 degrees. Now we can get the value of phi 1 by subtracting the sum of remaining angles from the sum of all angles. And we get phi 1 equals 90 degrees. The same value have phi 2 and phi 3. This means that the radii CT1, CT2, and CT3 are perpendicular to corresponding sides of triangle O1, O2, O3. Therefore, all sides of the triangle O1, O2, O3 are tangent to the circle, which means that the green circle is the inner circle of triangle O1, O2, O3. Let A, B, and C be the length of the sides of the triangle O1, O2, O3. There is a simple formula to evaluate the inner circle radius for a triangle. X equals A divided by S, where A is the area of the triangle, S is the semi-perimeter, half sum of all the sides. There is a number of YouTube videos dedicated to proving this formula, so I will not do it here. To calculate the area of the triangle, we will use Heron's formula, which also has a number of dedicated videos on YouTube. So we substitute the area from Heron's formula into the equation for the radius. In the denominator, I moved s under the square root, where it reduces with s in the numerator, and we get the formula for the radius of inner circle. Now we need to express the sides of the triangle in terms of radii r1, r2, and r3. It can be easily seen that A equals r2 plus r3, B equals r1 plus r3, C equals r1 plus r2. Then we evaluate the semi-perimeter, where each radius appears exactly twice. Then factors 2 are cancelled out, and we get just the sum of radii. Next, evaluate the other factors in Heron's formula. For S minus A, the radii nicely cancel out, and we get just r1. In the similar way, S minus B is r2, and S minus C is r3. And here is the final formula for the radius of the green circle. Substituting r1 equals 1, r2 equals 2, r3 equals 3 into the formula for the radius gives x equals 1. However, in this particular case, we can get away without Heron's formula. Calculating the sides of the triangle gives A equals 5, B equals 4, C equals 3. This is the famous Egyptian triangle, which is a right-angled triangle. Therefore, the area is just half product of the sides, which is 6, and we get 6 for the semi-perimeter as well. Therefore, the radius is again 1. This is consistent, this is great, and this is the end.